viewfinder captures more video victims, for you've been framed.
I think I'm gonna have to have some help. Let's see, would you put that camera down? I'm gonna...
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Jeremy Beadle.
Hi, and welcome to You've Been Framed, the show that stars you because you make it at home with your camcorders. And we've got some fantastic videos to share with you tonight. And let's kick off with an unusual game of rugby. Go! Now, ladies and gentlemen, a big thank you to the person who sent in that video, Paul O'Donoghue. And, of course, the star of the clip, the man who was tackled by the dog, Tim Ainsworth. Now, Tim, what team do you play for?
Broughton Park.
Mm-hmm. And what about the dog?
Oh, Hawkeston Rover.
No, I mean, how is the dog?
Oh, it's OK. Well, he's playing on Saturday for the first team.
There he is. What was the dog's name?
Oh, Lucky.
Not for you, but it was for us, because, of course, it was caught on a camcorder. Thank you very much indeed. Now, the dog was a bit of a handicap, but, of course, the one sport where you're well and truly handicapped is golf, especially if you're not the world's greatest player. The basic rules: bend your knees, keep your head still, and keep your balance. Watch a helpful hubby explain to his novice wife how to get ahead. This chap thinks it would be funny to make her miss by kicking the ball away. Some classic examples of misjudgment, but what we're about to show you is perhaps the finest piece of misjudgment ever captured on a camcorder. The situation's quite simple: videoing a garage when along comes a manager to park his car.
Buy a car and you want to kill them.
Absolutely extraordinary video, ladies and gentlemen. And the man behind the camera, Greg Rigby, tell us, how did you react when you were filming that?
Well, initially I was annoyed because I thought he was blocking the shot, but we had to laugh.
I bet you did. But what do you think of the odds of that actually happening?
Well, he must park there a million times, so it must be a million to one against, I guess.
It certainly was one in a million for us. Incredible. Thank you, Greg, for sending it along. And what's really interesting is that Greg there was using his video to record men at work. And that's what our next selection of videos is all about. It's the daring do's of men at work.
Don't work right.
Ha 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 ha!
This guy decided to save a fortune by doing his own car repairs. People complain that there's not enough rock and roll in You've Been Framed. Well, here's the rock.
Notice that most of the cock-ups that we show seem to involve men. Of course, that's because women never make mistakes, do they?
Yes!
Tell me something, gentlemen. Would you like to see a few clips where the women make a mess of things?
Yes!
OK, but ladies, remember, this wasn't my idea. That last clip, Mrs. Sylvia Cota. Sylvia, first of all, you weren't hurt?
No, not at all.
No?
Just my pride.
Just your pride, okay. Who actually took the video?
My granddaughter, Sylvia.
Sylvia? Sylvia, well, why didn't Sylvia help you?
She was too busy laughing.
Well, I tell you what, you'll both be laughing all the way to the bank because you're guaranteed £100, which is what we pay everyone whose clip we use on the show. And, of course, there's a £1,000 prize for the funniest British video of the show and a star prize of £5,000 for the funniest of the series. And if you win that, you'll definitely have something to celebrate, just like the families in these next couple of clips. These kids are taking no chances, but maybe this time Dad's actually got it right. And we've got lots more real corkers coming up in part two, so don't go anywhere. Just like this guy. Over the top.
In 1891, some of the country's finest dogs went to London. And Crufts was born, bringing pleasure to thousands of owners and dogs alike. 100 years on, the thrill of winning at the world's most famous dog show is as great as ever. But only one of them can be Crufts' supreme champion. And like so often in the past, it's a dog fed on pedigree chum and pedigree chum mixer. No wonder top breeders recommend it.
At Sharp, when we make a camcorder, it's simple enough for everyone to use. In fact, we only ever put more advanced features in, so you'll get more fun out. The extremely low-light shooting facility in this model, for instance, with the most powerful zoom lens and the only colour viewfinder you'll find. They're the sort of features that make a lot of sense, even when nothing else does. For camcorders and Nikam stereo video recorders, nothing makes sense like a Sharp.
The Yorkshire electricity sale is on now, with even lower prices. Huh. Buy now and you don't pay until May. That's unbeatable.
If Christmas made you feel the way I used to look, remember, far more people lose weight at Weight Watchers than at any other slimming club. Just look at the difference Weight Watchers made to my life. So if you want to lose weight, join Weight Watchers.
Join now and you'll save £8, because for January only, registration is free. Join Weight Watchers now and save £8. You'll find us in Yellow Pages or phone 0532 452 423.
I see Lung Polly are cutting up to £50 off Florida Walt Disney World holidays.
Get away!
Morning. Are you open, Yeti?
2 stones, please, pal. Muller, Muller, Grundy the stones.
Ah, goes down a treat.
What do you reckon?
Stones is great. Barman's abominable.
Wherever you may wander, there's no taste like Stones.
From the master of murder mysteries, Agatha Christie's Poirot, Sunday at 8:55 on ITV.
And a big welcome to the Selkirk Amateur Operatic Society, whose singing literally brought the house down. Now, first of all, David Mitchell, you sent us in the video. Why did it happen?
Well, during the concert, the choir were going up and down quite a lot. The chair must have got pushed back and one went too far.
Ian, what happened?
Well, the chairs were actually linked together. And when they sat back, one went, the whole went, lot went. And then we were all sitting there. Hands across their chest, folders across there, still sitting in the seats.
Rivet.
Brian, what happened next?
Well, as we fell, when we came back up, we all had to look for the music because it was all mixed up, you see, and everybody was going back and forward all the time.
David, what was the next song you sang?
Catch a Falling Star, of course.
It was. Listen, thanks to you all. That's absolutely marvellous. And thank you to David for sending in the clip. But, of course, the perils of performing in public just aren't restricted to adults. You should see what happens to children.
Careful little feet, where you go.
And someone should remind the little boy in the back row that this song is called Be Careful Little Feet, Where You Go. Two struggling actresses fighting their way to the top. Not all young actresses are rivals. The two starlets on the right couldn't be more attached to each other. A spectacular stage exit. Watch the girl on the right. Finally, a lad that won't be beaten by a drum.
Excuse me, sir. Don't mind just standing up. I can tell that you've got a real, real sense of adventure. What's your name?
Tony.
Correct. Marvellous. Follow me. You're really going to enjoy this. Now, come up here very quickly, Tony. I want you just to stand there. Come here. Now, you see this rope? I want you to swing on this like Tarzan. But what we've got to do is we've got to give you a fair run-up. So, you see this? I want you, first of all, to know that this here is a river, and it's full of crocodiles and wild piranhas. Do not tread on that, OK? Come over here. Well done, Tony. You're very, very good, OK? Now, I want you to turn around there, OK? Now, beat your chest like Tarzan. Now, do the noise.
Oh!
This is very good. I'm going to show you what I want you to do. You beat your chest, you make a noise, and then you run up there, watch the river, and you jump and you swing, and don't worry, I'll catch you. Right. Don't forget, beat your chest, watch the river. Are you ready? Go! Oh! Well, I tell you, that was a little unexpected. Mind you, so are most things in the great outdoors. Gentlemen, I'd like to introduce you to the star of our next video, Doreen Elsby and her beautiful doggy. Doreen, welcome. Welcome to the show. Would you first of all please explain to us what was supposed to happen in this video?
Well, we were supposed to be going to take the dogs over the field and the grandchildren. In the morning, I'd been over the field. In the daytime, the workmen had been there and digging up the stream. Well, when I got there in the evening, it was thick mud. So I thought there must be a way over there. So with that, I walked all the way round and I thought I was over.
Well, there we are. Incidentally, what is your doggy's name?
Lucky.
Lucky? Again?
We're not going to get out of the world. Are we? I'd be falling this mud.
Ha ha ha.
me. Oh, no. I'm sinking. Bloody hell.
To Doreen's son and daughter-in-law, Will and Julia, for sending in that video, and a big thank you to Doreen Elsby, and of course, not forgetting Lucky. And someone's going to be lucky tonight because they're going to win £1,000 for sending us the funniest British video of the show. But it's not winning that's important, it's the taking part, no matter how daft the game. And the masters of the silly game are the Japanese. Some magic moments from the land of the rising sun, but now it's time to discover which was the funniest British clip in tonight's show. Every member of the audience, apart from those involved in the clips, has one of these electronic keypads, which they'll vote for their funniest clips by pressing 1, 2, or 3. And here are the three videos shortlisted for the final vote. Number 1, Hull Kingston Rover. Number 2, a chorus line. Number 3, Lucky Lady. Well, they're all winners as far as I'm concerned, but it's up to our audience to decide which is the funniest. Audience, please vote now. So now, ladies and gentlemen, the moment of truth, when our computer reveals which, according to our audience, is the funniest clip. And it is... Number 3 is Doreen Elsby and Lucky. Now... tell you. Well done. Thank you. Well done, Lucky. But of course, it's not Doreen that gets £1,000. The £1,000 goes to the person who sent in the clip, and that was her son. So I hope you're going to share some with Lucky and your mum.
I will do, yeah.
Good for you. Okay. Sadly, ladies and gentlemen, that's all we've got time for tonight. Oh. Would you like some more?
Yes!
Okay. Just for you.
I don't think she knows where to go.
Uh-oh, this is gonna be good. Watch this.
Time for, but please keep your clips coming in, because next time the star of the show could be you. Good night.
If you've captured a magical moment on your camcorder, it could win you £5,000. Send it to You've Been Framed, Granada Television, Manchester, M60 9EA, and we promise to return all your tapes.
And You've Been Framed returns with more gems next Sunday at the same time, 8:05.